Hi, I'm Samir, and now we are going to learn some techniques to multiply two numbers faster. Let us begin by taking 12 and 14 as an example. If we look closely at these numbers, they are both close to 10. The numbers such as 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, etc. would be very special to us, as they make our calculations much easier. In our case, the base would be 10. Now, we will proceed to find out the difference of the given number from our base. 12 minus 10 is plus 2 and 14 minus 10 is plus 4. Having determined the differences, we can now proceed to write down our answer, which would be in two parts. The first part would be the first number added to the difference obtained from the second part, which is plus 4. So 12 plus 4 is 16. The second part would be the product of the differences, which is plus 2 into plus 4, which gives us 8. We can write down our final answer by clubbing these two parts, which is 1, 6, 8. Interesting observation. What we did was added 12 to 4. We could have also taken the second number and added to the difference obtained from the first part, which would have been 14 plus 2, giving us 16. So it is the same thing. Let us take another example, 109 into 106. Both these numbers are close to 100. So our base would be 100 and the differences would be plus 9 and plus 6. We can now proceed to write down our answer, which would be again in two parts. First part would be the first number 109 added to the difference obtained from second, which is plus 6, which gives us 115. And the second part would be the product of the differences, which is plus 9 into plus 6, 54. So we can club these two and get our final answer as 11554. Let us now take an example with bigger numbers, 113 into 112. Again, both these numbers are close to 100. So our chosen base will be 100 and the differences would be plus 13 and plus 12. Now we can proceed to write down our answer, which would again be in two parts. 113, the first number added to the difference obtained from the second, which was plus 12, which gives us 125. Now the second part would be the product of differences, plus 13 into plus 12, which is 156. Here comes our first rule, which says the number of digits in the second part will always be equal to the number of zeros in our base, which in this case was 2. So 1 has to be carried over to the first part, making 125 as 126, and we'll be left with 56 in the second part. Hence our answer would be 12656. So far we have seen the numbers were always greater than the base. How about trying an example where the numbers are less than the base? Let us take 91 into 87 as an example. Our base here again would be 100, as both these numbers are close to it, and the differences would be 91 minus 100 minus 9 and 87 minus 100 minus 13. We can now proceed to write down our answer, which would again be in two parts. First part would be 91 added to the difference obtained from the second minus 13, which would give us 78. And the second part would be the product of the differences, which is minus 9 into minus 13, which will give us 117. Here comes our first rule. The number of digits in second part will be equal to the number of zeros in our chosen base, which in our case is only 2. So 1 has to be carried over to the first part, making the 78 as 78 plus 1, 79, and we'll be left with 17 in the second part. Clubbing these two, we get our final answer as 7917. Let us now take an example where one of the numbers is greater than the base and the other less than it. 112 into 92 is one such example. The chosen base again would be 100, as both 112 and 92 are close to it, and the differences would be plus 12 and minus 8. Now let us proceed to write down our answer, which would again be in two parts. The first part would be 112 added to the difference obtained from the second, which is minus 8, which will give us 104. And the second part would be the product of the differences, which is 12 into minus 8, which will give us minus 96. Here comes in our second rule, that the number in the second part would never be negative. So make it positive, we'll need to borrow 1 from the first part, which would become 100 as our base has two zeros. So one borrowed will take the two zeros and will become 100. And the first part will lose one, which will make it 103. And the second part would be 100 minus 96, which will give us 4. Here comes in our first rule. The number of digits would have to be equal to the number of zeros in our base, which is 2. So we'll have to add an additional zero in front of 4. And hence our final answer would be 10304. Let us now try 1000 as our base. So how about multiplying 1009 into 1008? Here the differences would be plus 9 and plus 8. Now let us proceed to write down our answer, which would be 1009 plus the difference obtained from the second number plus 8. So it will give us 1017. And the second part would be plus 9 into 8, 72. Here comes in our first rule. So we'll have to add an additional zero to make it a three-digit number, as 1000 has three zeros. So it'll become 072, and our answer would be 1017072. Hope you have enjoyed learning these techniques. Needless to say, you will need a lot of practice to master them. Catch you in next video with some more tricks.